Hey there, friends, family, and loved ones, and Biomag healers all. I want to share something very, very exciting, which I've just come up with, and I want to share with you all because it may be a great healing modality addition to the beginnings of the Biomag Academy of Spiritual Science and developing new products and ways to help and to heal. So this is something I've been thinking about for quite some time based on Dr. Garcia's protocols on Open Sesame, on what's going on in our brains. He's got a trauma brain injury protocol. He's got placements for many issues. But here, just to give you a background, the magnetic mineral magnetite in the human brain turns the brainstem maybe full of it. Yes, it is. It's hard to read, but this shows a chart, proof of magnetics in the brain. There's 5 million magnetite crystals per gram of brain cell and 100 million magnetite crystals per gram in the cerebral cortex. Our brains are loaded with magnets, so biomagnetism makes sense. So these are Dr. Garcia's placements, and here I made a model on a mannequin's head, and I did the placements all around the head. That cover, just in the head alone, these placements cover common cold, fever, flu symptoms, runny nose, TMJ, respiratory, diarrhea, mold, huge, tooth pain, bleeding gums, shortness of breath, eye strain. Anybody relating here? Brain fog, sexual appetite, muscle pain, bronchitis, laryngitis, self-esteem, drug addiction. Had great success with the drug addictions and anxiety, depression, panic attacks, aggression, fear, irritability, loneliness, moody, suicidal, inspiration, intuition, pineal gland, elderly, temperature control, children, all of these with head placements. And then Dr. Garcia brilliantly has come up with this trauma brain injury chart that he developed himself that shows the different placements for brain injuries. And he was going around to schools, colleges and high schools, and those that had gotten head concussions, he was able to alleviate the brain inflammation and head concussion and many other issues with this trauma brain injury protocol that he developed. Yeah. Can you feel it, baby? I can too. So here are the placements, just some of the placements that will be assisted by the God helmet. And you can see these placements, pineal, medulla, pineal, pineal. So a muscle test to find out for sure, black, and you see the images here. If you see the red, it goes reverse against the skin. Just flip it over, put it on the skin. If I see red here, I'm going to flip it against the medulla. But muscle test to make sure these placements are correct. And if you haven't learned a muscle test, you need to do that, please, before you start applying the magnets in the God helmet so you're doing this correctly. So these will deal with different issues of emotions, affects nervous system, respiratory, tingling, numbness, and also low libido, anxiety, depression, pineal gland, regulates, reproduces hormones, just in those two sets of placements alone. Then we have extreme aggressiveness, anorexia, balance, urinary tract help, assistance, again, the temporal lobes for rickettsia, anxiety, insomnia, headaches, irritability, muscle aches, just in the temporal lobe. So again, black on the right against the skin, red on the left against the skin. It's already there. You just need to activate it by setting your intention. Please set my intention to activate the God helmet, the temporal lobe placements, to help me with this. And that's all you need to do. Circle of Willis. So all you do is set the placements for here. If you want to start activating for improving dementia, brain fog, your eyes, insomnia, just go through this and you can see these placements are already there. You set your intention, to activate for 15 minutes if you're along the lateral between New York and San Francisco. If you're up near Canada, activate for 20, 22 minutes. If you're down in Mexico down there, you only need 5, 6, 7 minutes. Set your intention. How about if you want to do for halitosis, multiple sclerosis, digestive system, endocarditis, bladder, nervous system? How about for with experiencing low energy, neck and back pain, stress? All these placements can be done with the Biomag helmet alone, all right? And some are different placements on different parts of the body. We're going to get a bodysuit, Biomag wearables, folks. We're going to make Biomag wearables. So again, you can place these on your uterus. You can do different placements as well. Put the helmet on and then add placements. But here again, for depression, for loneliness, it's all covered in the Biomag helmet. So we can all do this and we can activate it. And then also you can activate the code for emotional placements, R688. So if you want to just activate the code for R688, you put the Biomag helmet on. Please activate all the codes that are relevant and the placements that are relevant to assist in my with the God helmet I have placed on today. Please provide all assistance possible to assist me in balancing my pH levels into homeostasis and my energy levels. And that's all you have to do is set your intention and then let it do its stuff. Love to hear back any reports once you do this. Thanks.
I guess I was sort of in a state of fear where I didn't want to turn around and look.
A very friendly, welcoming feeling at one instance.
I was starting to feel very anxious and very cold.
The outlines of a human body.
Almost complete and total panic.
Very visual experiences. One of the first ones.
Here at Laurentian University in Sudbury, Ontario, a team is investigating certain common perceptions of the inner mind.
So we'll be taking a baseline recording first. Mm-hmm.
Right now, they're looking at the electromagnetic brain patterns seen in people having the near-death experience. The research is led by Dr. Michael Persinger.
Basically, at any given time, all experience is due to those portions of the brain that are most metabolically active.
All right, so here's all you do. You take this and you thread the screw through. And here's right here. Okay. And
if we can simulate that by applying complex, meaningful magnetic fields to the brain, we can also induce those experiences.
If we can simulate that by applying complex, meaningful magnetic fields to the brain, we can also induce those experiences.
The volunteer sits blindfolded in a soundproof chamber. This sensory deprivation allows the mind to focus on electromagnetic patterns transmitted across the brain through this modified crash helmet.
If you feel anything change with the electrodes?
They're able to simulate the exact brain patterns that occur in near-death experiences.
Is that comfortable?
What we've been doing recently is generating words as magnetic patterns. And even though the person isn't hearing it through their ears, their brain is interpreting it. So they're actually having fragments of experiences as if they're hearing it, when in actual fact they cannot be.
These experiences are so strong, they're utterly real for the person who has them. They can be as profound as a religious conversion, yet we can generate them with a machine. These mind games are beginning to shed their secrets. The scientist becomes the shaman.
But one thing that's really clear, you can control the person's experiences and they don't know they're being controlled. That's why this technology is a potentially powerful one and has a two-edge to its sword.
So this is part of the evildoers' plan, the brain initiative, which we may have a possibility to mitigate as they're trying to control our brains through remote brain targeting and using the Human Brain Project. This is part of the whole design of the you know what's, and also the Schwab testing as well, is to control us and to use the magnetos for the cytokine protein, spike proteins that are going throughout the body. And from our brain, this is an EKG. So I'm thinking, well, how can we get where we could have something where we could wear a hat that has all Dr. Garcia's placements and all those issues for the head that deal with emotional, physical trauma, depression, loneliness? What could we do to stimulate all those brain cells where we need to in the cerebral cortex, which is very complicated, but where I'm guessing maybe 80, 90% of our physical issues are generated from the brain. All right. So if we can help with the brain and we can bring that into homeostasis and balance, what can we do for the entire body? And just all these things about different areas we could focus on in creative thought, writing, intellect, stimulation, emotional reaction, musical, fear, reading, all dealing with the brain, all dealing with energy in the brain with the magnetites. And then this is a picture of the different magnets pulling universal, where you can see the different activities of using magnets on the brain. So how can we apply that to our brains better? Ladies and gentlemen, now this can help with brain fog, uncertainty, and isolation in our minds, putting the skull cap on for 15 minutes. This is a normal brain versus a brain on Adderall. Can we do the same effect using that? Deep brain stimulation, getting the nerves going, activating the crown chakra, activating the third eye chakra, temperature control, depression, loneliness, stimulating the temple, medulla, cerebellum. I mean, this is the universe. This is our brain cell. Are we connecting to the universe? Are we bringing us back into homeostasis by putting on the skull cap? We're dealing with the waves of the brain, the beta, the alpha, the delta, the theta, and the gamma. So again, all of these would be stimulated or can be possibly stimulated. And then you can set your intention for which specific areas you want to set in your helmet that you're wearing. And can you, you want to improve your hearing. So you will activate the magnets that'll stimulate that with your intention, or you can stimulate different parts of the brain with your intention, or just put the biomagnetic helmet on, and we'll be addressing all these issues all in one. Could be exciting, could be fun. How about the temporal lobe, spotted fever, Lyme disease, ticks, lice, insomnia, headaches, irritability, nervousness, fever, black right above the ear on the right side, red right above, we got that covered. Covers anxiety. How about migraines, hypertension, stress, all in the brain can be helped with the biomagnetic heal net. 12 cranials, you can focus your intention on which ones you want to activate with the heal net on, helmet, skull cap, biomagnetic skull cap, biomagnetic skull netics. I don't know, we'll come up with something. So anyway, you can focus your intentions and you can muscle scan where you want to activate the different placements on the magnetic helmet with just your intention based on which issues you want to focus on.
Here at Laurentian University in Sudbury, Ontario, a team is investigating certain common perceptions of the inner mind.
So we'll be taking a baseline recording first.
Right now, they're looking at the electromagnetic brain patterns seen in people having the near-death experience. The research is led by Dr. Michael Persinger.
Basically, at any given time, all experience is due to those portions of the brain that are most metabolically active. If we can simulate that by applying complex, meaningful magnetic fields to the brain, we can also induce those experiences.
This experiment is testing the idea that mystical perceptions and paranormal experiences can be turned on at will, not by hypnosis or shamanic drumming, but by a scientist stimulating nerve activity in the brain. The volunteer sits blindfolded in a soundproof chamber. This sensory deprivation allows the mind to focus on electromagnetic patterns transmitted across the brain through this modified crash helmet.
If you feel anything change with the electrodes.
They're able to simulate the exact brain patterns that occur in near-death experiences.
Is that comfortable?
Dr. Persinger hopes the research will benefit psychotherapy.
We tried to evoke the fragments that compose the near-death experience and other mystical experiences, such as detachment, feelings of moving through a tunnel, hearing voices, the sense of a presence, usually on the left side. Our major thrust is ultimately to apply this to dealing with things such as psychological depression. if you stimulate the deep portions of the temporal lobe, so you can get very, very vivid imagery, and the emotional commitment or the emotional sensation that something is profound, real, cosmically real, and personally significant.
You can't really hear. You can tell that it's someone talking. You can distinguish that. But you can't make out any kind of words or anything like that.
What we've been doing recently is generating words as magnetic patterns. And even though the person isn't hearing it through their ears, their brain is interpreting it. So they're actually having fragments of experiences as if they're hearing it, when in actual fact they cannot be.
These experiences are so strong, they're utterly real for the person who has them. They can be as profound as a religious conversion, yet we can generate them with a machine. These mind games are beginning to shed their secrets. The scientist becomes the shaman. But where are the limits? What else can people be made to believe?
So it could be super easy. Sleep protocol, you got some sleep issues. That could be dealt with. Here's some placements you want to deal with when you look up your issues and find them. So this is what I came up with, was all the placements that are for shortness of breath, headaches, tinnitus, fear, depression, loneliness. And so you just look at this chart and then you'd apply the biomagnetic helmet. But I'm trying to figure out, well, how can we get the face too? We got the hat, we got the head, but we need to get the face to cover more things. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the God helmet. Not reinventing the wheel, just returning the wheel. Spiritual science, energy, vibration, frequency, healing. That's what this is about. So I just ordered it. I'll put it on the notes here. How I did it, it was $24 or so for a MMA hat, helmet, on Amazon. And then I got 68, total of 34 pairs on the Biomag God helmet. And you can see in the back here, just going around the ears, covering all these issues with temperature control, body control, temple, anger, depression, loneliness, fear, anxiety, sinuses, toothaches, depression, ringing in the ears. All these are going to help with the issues so many of us have. Now, inside of here,
potentiality in these skull caps that I think everybody, that's why I'm putting it out there. So possibly everyone can make their own, get one, try it on, put it in their homes, have it for themselves, and maybe help with controlling and mitigating and helping with the mind and the body and the spirit by using these skull caps that are very simple and easy to use. And again, you can make them yourself, or I'll be happy to make them for me. Just contact me and let me know.
It ain't going anywhere. That's in there. And then you can take it out and change it. And again, it's like $25 to get these. So I highly encourage everyone to make their own. The God helmet. You can't get hurt with magnets, folks. The doctors have declared and said and proven over and over again. What the heck? If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But if you get it to work, what's the benefit? Okay, so it's $24 for parts. I call it a buck a magnet, maybe. That's $80 for magnets and a drill and some screws and nuts. And for $100, you got your own God helmet. Or I'll make you one for $450, $500, something like that. You decide, but I'll also include the pictures of what the different placements do so you understand. And someday I want to get LED lights on here too, where you can LED the codes. So I'm having emotional codes, and these lights would light up, and you can add additional power without muscle testing. It would program to help you in those different areas. And since that's the other beauty of this helmet, is I can add magnets, no problem. Boom. So Dr. Goyes was doing about power and having more powerful magnets, and Dr. Garcia says, well, when you find your scans, you'll be adding magnets naturally, so you'll be adding power as you go. And that made more sense to me, so that's why I work. But here we can just do
our own little magnets, and boom, you know, I want red on there, whatever. Simple, easy, adjustable, adaptable, and inexpensive. The God helmet, it can be yours today. Get it while you can, share with all, get children sizes, try these with your children. Depression, loneliness, anger, and frustration, confusion, all these things children are feeling today. The maxillary sinus or respiratory issues, sinusitis, which everybody's getting, hypersensitivity. That's why you see when you first saw the magnets stick to the arm, and then a week later they stuck to the chest, and a week later they stuck to the head, because they're spreading through magnets throughout the body. So can this biomagnetic helmet, can that help mitigate some of the influences? Well, they're using magnets to control the brain. Here we see one potential for loose solution, high efficacy, remote control, the neural activity deep in the brain would use conventional magnetic nanoparticles to locally amplify the magnetic field and thus enhance the effective coupling to local electric currents. So will this biomagnetic helmet, will this mitigate some of their effects of them trying to control our brains? An even more dramatic solution could be achieved by using a novel class of functional nanoparticles known as magnetoelectric nanoparticles. The magnetic field exposure not only amplify the local magnetic field, but generate additional local electric fields. So we're going to be balancing into homeostasis, where these mitigating dark energy fields are being introduced into our brains, into our bodies in so many different ways, whether it's aerosol spraying, whether it's from the food, whether it's from the injections, whether it's from the nose test. We're being nanoed with magnets. So this may be a possibility, a big possibility, with mitigating some of the effects of what they're doing to us. So again, it's to provide, this is their game, to provide external access to internal bioelectric and neural circuits. In other words, they're enabling a unique way to combine the advantages of both the high efficacy of electric fields and external control capability of the magnetic fields, and therefore an open novel pathway to control them. This is their game, controlling our brains with remote control using magnets, right? So they've been working on this for a very long time. It's called 3D mapping. They spend billions a year to do it every single year. They spend all this money. And then you have the national security of the 21st century soon connect human brains to silicon chips. More than 2/3 of the satellites are foreign owned. They're trying to connect genetically engineered pathogens that will thwart biodetection and also manipulate your brain. This is the brain, the chip brain that they wish to control. This is the great reset, which they're seeing. And here you can see they have all the different frequencies for controlling human behavior. It's not very clear, but you get the idea, chip on the brain. That's what they're putting in, all this stuff that's going throughout our bodies. This God helmet may help them. And I'm not talking about God helmet because I'm saying this is what coming from me. This is the quote science of the past. And this is what they called it, using magnets. Check it out.
Dr. Persinger hopes the research will benefit psychotherapy.
We tried to evoke the fragments that compose the near-death experience and other mystical experiences, such as detachment, feelings of moving through a tunnel, hearing voices, the sense of a presence, usually on the left side. Our major thrust is ultimately to apply this to dealing with things such as psychological depression.
After a while, I remember feeling that there was someone else in the room with me, almost looking over my left shoulder. It was all I could do to not turn my head and want to look.
If you stimulate the deep portions of the temporal lobe, so you can get very, very vivid imagery, and the emotional commitment or the emotional sensation that something is profound, real, cosmically real, and personally significant.
It's a male voice, but it's like really, really far away. As if you can just sort of like catch
a tone you can't really hear. You can tell that it's someone talking. You can distinguish that. But you can't make out any kind of words or anything like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the God helmet. Not reinventing the wheel, just returning the wheel. Spiritual science, energy, vibration, frequency, healing. That's what this is about. So I just ordered this. I'll put it on the notes here. How I did it, it was $24 or so for a MMA hat, helmet, on Amazon. And then the I got about, I think I got 68 total of 34 pairs on the Biomag God helmet. And you can see in the back here, just going around the ears, covering all these issues with temperature control, body control, temple, anger, depression, loneliness, fear, anxiety, sinuses, toothaches, depression, ringing in the ears. All these are going to help with the issues so many of us have. Now inside of here, so here we have on the top the four cardinal points, black on the right, red on the left of the skull, the parietal, pineal gland, the crown chakras, all those are addressed with those. And then on the back here, on the inside of the back of the head, the occipital bone, in all the areas, the amygdala, the pineal gland as well, the medulla, the cerebellum, can all be accessed with this in the back. And it's faced with a padding, so you're not going to feel it at the back of your head. And then also another trick I little did was, my head's a little bigger than most. This is a large, extra large combo, and it does have straps, but it still felt a little pressure on the skull. So I just did some incision cuts on the stretch band to allow less pressure, and it worked fine. So that's a thing for people with bigger heads or hair, whatever, can adjust to. You can't get hurt with magnets, folks. The doctors have declared and said and proven over and over again. What the heck? If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But if you get it to work, what's the benefit? Okay, so it's $24 for parts. I call it a buck a magnet, maybe. That's $80 for magnets and a drill and some screws and nuts. And for $100, you got your own God helmet. Or I'll make you one for $350, $500, something like that. You decide, but I'll send also include the pictures of what the different placements do so you understand. And someday I want to get LED lights on here too, where you can LED the codes. So I'm having emotional codes, and these lights would light up, and you can add additional power without muscle testing. It would program to help you in those different areas. And since that's the other beauty of this helmet, is I can add magnets, no problem. Boom. So Dr. Goyes was doing about power and having more powerful magnets, and Dr. Garcia says, well, when you find your scans, you'll be adding magnets naturally, so you'll be adding power as you go. And that made more sense to me, so that's why I work. But here we can just do our own little magnets, and boom, you know, I want red on there, whatever. Simple, easy, adjustable, adaptable, and inexpensive. The God helmet, it can be yours today. Get it while you can, share with all, get children sizes, try these with your children. Depression, loneliness, anger, and frustration, confusion, all these things children are feeling today, this God helmet may help them. And I'm not talking about God helmet because I'm saying this is coming from me. This is the, quote, science of the past. And this is what they called it, using magnets. Check it out.
In the laboratory, we have reproduced every aspect of the God experience, every essence, every component of it, from the rising sensation to the feelings of ecstasy, to the feelings of a sensed presence, to the feelings that you're at one with the universe. We can do that experimentally.
Professor Persinger has gone straight to the source of creativity, emotion, and fantasy by stimulating this area, the temporal lobes and the limbic system, with complex magnetic fields that set up electrical charges in the brain. In our presence, one subject had a near-death experience.
A sudden wave of darkness. It's a distant point of light.
No two people have responded in exactly the same way. But all of them come out of this chamber with a profound sense that something hugely significant has taken place.
It's a sound chamber that doesn't allow anything from the outside to come inside. And I start hearing voices. I start seeing things.
Started with faces. There was a lot of faces, but distorted faces, moving kind of, almost like seeing something through heat.
I felt a presence behind me, like kind of staring down at me, and It seemed very strange.
This presence was, it wasn't frightening at all. It was very comforting, actually.
It was like dreaming, but I was awake. Just like when you have a dream, sometimes you wake up and your dreams are just so, it was so real.
What we have found is that individuals who show a temporal lobe sensitivity or creativity and who are very religious, in that setting, they will have a religious experience. We can generate the sensed presence, which is defined as God.
So the God helmet is Dr. Persinger's magnetic helmet, induces feelings of mystical experiences. So here's a picture of his helmet, for people wearing it. And you can see there's just some holes in the helmet and then a little cardboard box over the top of there and stuff, right, with some wires connected to it. But he's using magnets to stimulate brain energy, right? So Wikipedia, the font of all knowledge, is an experimental, says the God helmet is an experimental apparatus originally called the Corin helmet after its inventor, Stanley Corin. It was developed by neuroscientist Michael Persinger to study creativity, religious experience, and the effects of subtle stimulation of the temporal lobes. Reports by participants of a, quote, sensed presence, end quote, while wearing the God helmet. The study purported neural correlations of neurology of religion and spirituality. The magnets generate a very weak field, doesn't harm you, and like other neurostimulation, it's low intensity magnetic fields. It's also a million times, but far weaker than the ordinary, is a million times weaker than transcranial magnetic stimulation. And he reports that subjects reported having mystical experiences in altered states. How does it work? It utilizes a network of low intensity magnetic signals or a field-to-field interaction into the brain, mildly disrupting the brain, which causes the left and the right side to communicate specifically about a sensed or religious presence. According to Persinger, who tested the God helmet on more than 2,000 subjects, up to 80% state that mild disruption that the God helmet provides create a sensed presence. And Dr. McCoy can testify to this. Star Trek predictive programming, Gene Roddenberry, 33 degree Freemason. They've been knowing about this for a very, very long time, as I covered earlier here. But what I wanted to get back to, get the gook, is we can focus our intentions towards these areas and use this device in the way it was intended with our intentions added to it. So we can make it even more powerful with this easy to make device. It produces magnetic fields that Persinger describes as a weak but complex fluctuation in magnetic fields derived from physiological sources. It affects the effects of geomagnetism on the human brain. And reports similar effects with this apparatus using magnetic fields employed in TMS and Persinger experiments. Persinger's apparatus uses weak complex magnetic signals patterned after physiological process, such as one derived from limbic burst firing. So here's a picture of the helmet, the God helmet that he used again. So Persinger designed the God helmet to create conditions or sense of self from both cerebral hemispheres is disrupted. When communication between the left and right senses of the self is disturbed, the usually subordinate self, this is in the astral plane he's talking about here, the subconscious, the usually subordinate self in the right hemisphere intrudes into the awareness of the left hemispheric brain. It can also be the right side, left side hemispheric balancing also with this, where the yin and the yang, the male and the female, the right and the left brain, the analytical male, break it down, testosterone, and then the female, the other side, receptive, nurture, nature, that kind of thing. Those start harmonizing more too. So many paranormal experiences have been reported, feelings of having lived past lives, presences of non-physical beings, ghosts, muses, and other spiritual beings are examples of interhemispheric intrusions, not intrusions, guides, to validate the idea that religious and mystic experience are artifacts, no, they're not, they're experiences, you knuckleheads. Get it, knuckle?
reports similar effects with this apparatus, as apparatus uses weak magnets. You already know all this. Again, all the magnetite in our brain being stimulated. And also the way everybody's neocortex folds differently. So everybody has a little different way of looking at the world. So never two suns are alike, but homeostasis is a universal healing. All right. So when it stimulated the right hemisphere, we're surprised to find many people reported a sensed presence, a feeling of sentient being standing nearby. All right. Your right side is your positive side. That's your male side. That's your side that's the dominant. And it suddenly struck us that what the right hemisphere experience is, the sense presence is the right hemispheric equivalent to the left hemispheric sense of self. And the minute we knew that, everything fell into place. So is the subconscious experiencing self? Is this what is experiencing going through this? I can answer that, and I can tell you definitely yes. So often in killing each other to determine whose God that verifies sense presence is the strongest. So Persinger says a sense of self, it's a primary language-based phenomenon, primarily involving more left hemispheric activities. The right hemispheric, by contrast, is the intuitive, emotional hemisphere, and this is where inspiration strikes. So Professor Korn, to help him design a helmet that would be able to apply magnetic fields to temporal lobes. That's what we're doing with the Biomag helmet right here. You got everybody can make. All you're doing is stimulating the magnetic fields in the temporal lobes and other places. Hearing, speech, processing, sensory information, all can benefit. Wahoo! I already talked about that. So this is kind of interesting a little bit here. At least 80% of the subjects, Persinger said, sense the presence. Females are very receptive. They're used to introspection. At least one subject tore the helmet from his head and ran from the room. They might call presence, they felt God. General trends and people see have largely remained the same, he says, over the last 30 years of doing this, 30 years. And again, we have three different effects of energy fields in the magnetic fields. We have the push, the same. We have the opposites attracting, pull, push. And then we have the toroidal field of the circular uretisol egg. So the basic mechanism by which sense presence occurs, that there is an enhancement of the right hemispheric activity, and that ultimately ends up being represented within the left hemisphere, and you become aware of it. Conscious awareness activated. Because we can't have two selves, the information is re-understood to be coming from someone else entirely, a presence. When it's just another, it's a connection to a deeper consciousness. And here's how we talked about the doing of 100 million magnetite crystals. Remember, we use a magnetite. So brain fog, again, this is, can help serious brain fog a lot of people are having today. And just to close this down, these are the wood screws. Take a snapshot, stop, look, order. Number fours by, or you can do six by 3/4, actually it should be. And then here's the ring magnets you want to order, 5/8 inch, countersunk, and total element right here. So there you go. And get your helmets, get them made, and happy healing, happy consciousness rising, happy self-awareness, happy children, happy people, happy everything. Let me hear your reports. Let me hear what you think, and let me hear what happens. I'm very, very interested to hear your feedback. Thank you so much for spending time. And I hope you take the time to go and do this. I think it'll be very exciting for all. Peace. All right, so here's all you do. You take this and you thread the screw through, and here's right here. Okay. And you can get 10 packs of magnets from Total Elements, totalelements.com. And then here's your screw, okay, right? I'm just going to set this down. It ain't going anywhere. That's in there. And then you can take it out and change it. And again, it's like $25 to get these. So I highly encourage everyone to make their own. the God helmet. Okay, so it's super easy. Everybody can do this. So this is where it starts out at. They may have colored ones if you want colored ones, but it's nice and thick padding. All right, so here's all you have to do. You grab some wood screws. These are 6x34 wood screws, okay? 6x3/4, I'm sorry. And then you got the magnets. These are neodymium N52s, and they're countersunk. So the screw will go right in there, and then there's a positive and a negative. And the way you check for positive and negative is with telling which side. So if it's resisting, right now it's resisting, so that means it's red on red, so red goes in the bottom. So if I want to do red, this is the bottom where my thumb is. My thumb is always on the top. So I always put my thumb on top of what I want on top, which means that what I want against the skin or against the down is going to be the active black on the right, red on the left, 90% of the time, but that's not always true. And I did do some placements on this helmet too for temperature control and temple activities that had a black and a red in a horizontal and a couple verticals too, and I'll make a map of that.